Joined now from Washington by Democratic Texas State Representative Rafael Anchia, chair of the Mexican American Legislative Caucus. Thanks so much for being here.
Good to be with you. Thanks for having me.
And as you know, Texas Governor Abbott can just continue calling special sessions to bring up the voting legislation, even if you're able to wait out this month-long session staying in Washington, and you simply don't have the votes to stop this from moving forward in Texas legislature. So what's your end game here? How long are you prepared to essentially not do the job that voters elected you to do in Austin?
Well, we're doing the job that we were elected to do, which is to uphold the Constitution and protect our very sacred right to vote. And we're here working. We're meeting with members of the Congress, Senate side, House side, meeting with our elected representatives and talking about a number of different issues, including that very precious and sacred right to vote. The bottom line is that we have Democrats united to wait out this session, to kill the not only this voting rights bill, but all the other extreme bills that Governor Abbott has added to the call, including bills to attack transgender youth, bills to negatively impact women's health, bills to build a border wall. And he poisoned the well at the beginning of the session by defunding the legislative branch, vetoing the funding for a co-equal branch of government. And then he feigns to be a constitutional conservative and say, hey, I believe in the separation of powers. You all should just come back and do your job, when in fact he has defunded our legislative branch. So this session started with bad faith on behalf of the governor. We're ready to come back and work on a bipartisan basis on a bill that we draw together, that we develop together. But that's just not happening in Texas. We had members on a select committee sit through 24 hours of testimony, overwhelmingly against these bills that limit our right to vote and our freedom to vote. Yet Republicans rejected every amendment that we offered up. The bottom line is they want to do this for political gain. They're not trying to develop good policy. This isn't about election integrity. In fact, the Republican Secretary of State said our elections were safe, secure, and successful. They're really trying to gain a partisan advantage. So by leaving the state, we're protecting Texans' right to vote.
And you say that your goal is to draw attention to federal legislation on voting rights, but Democrats in Washington also don't have the votes to debate that legislation without changing the filibuster. Several Democrats, not just Joe Manchin, have expressed reservations about changing those Senate procedures. Do you think that this type of public pressure, though, might change that?
Well, look, the last time the Voting Rights Act was reauthorized, it was under President George W. Bush, another well-known Texan, and it was done on a bipartisan basis. My view is that voting rights should not be a Democratic issue or a Republican issue. It should cut down at the heart of this country and the broad middle of this country, and we should make election laws that make it easier to vote and harder to cheat. And that's our goal as Democrats. We're ready to lock arms with Republicans and do this work. We're calling on our federal representatives to do the same thing and pass federal legislation that will protect Texas and Texas voters.
And who do you plan to meet with in the coming days in Washington to try to get movement on this federal legislation?
Well, we've already started meeting with members of the U.S. Senate, House members. That happened today. We met with the vice president today, Leader Schumer, to share ideas and experiences about what's happening in Texas. I mean, you know, the funny thing is the governor fails to mention that Texas has been found to intentionally discriminate against its voters on 10 different occasions during the last decade alone. That occurred in three federal courts, including one federal court that had a Republican majority. They found intentional discrimination by the state of Texas. So look, if Texas wants to empower voters, great. We're all for a Texas Voting Rights Act. But if they want to make negatively impact the freedom to vote, make it harder to vote, then they better show a good reason why and not come to Texas with the big lie.
And lastly, your Republican counterparts in Texas are calling this all political theater. But what do you say to your constituents in Texas who may be opposed to some of these voting measures, but who think that fleeing the state on a private plane to Washington is the wrong way to go about addressing this?
Well, look, we came to this legislative session in good faith. We offered up amendments to try to improve the bill. We had hundreds of Texans come out, wait all night, and testify against this bill. So the political theater was actually that committee hearing where the members of the majority on a party line vote rejected our amendments and then jammed through this bill that everybody testified against. I mean, of the 500 Texans that came out to testify and wait 24 hours, over 400 of them opposed the bill, yet they passed it anyway. So if anybody is engaging in political theater for political gain, it's my friends on the other side of the aisle.
Our thanks to Texas State Representative Rafael Anchia. Appreciate your time tonight.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.